Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this cheesy spinach soup that will help you on your fibroid shrinking journey. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knudsen and I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female related conditions using food as medicine. This soup is healthy and it's filled with flavor and texture. It's perfect when you're in the mood for some comfort food. Let's go in the kitchen and see how to make this soup. As you can see, I've already added some water to the bottom of this pan, if you can see the steam coming up. But don't worry, I'm going to put the recipe down in the description box so that you know exactly how to make this recipe. We're starting off with one yellow onion. I'm also using my Instant Pot for this recipe. You can use your regular stovetop to make this recipe. The instructions for both are down below in the description box. And really, all you need to do is add everything to either the Instant Pot or the pot that you're using to cook on top of the stove. At the time I was recording the video, I wasn't quite sure how I was going to do it, so that's why you see me layering the ingredients into the pot. Next, I'm going to add my favorite mushrooms, which are shiitake mushrooms. The reason I like these mushrooms is because they have like a chewy consistency to them. It almost feels like it's meaty, if you will. So that's why I use them often. Next, we're gonna add our vegetable broth. Make sure you use vegetable broth and not chicken stock or beef stock or anything like that. Use vegetable broth. Next, we're gonna add our tomato sauce. You can either use boxed or a can that is BPA free. This is organic and no salt added. We're stirring it around a bit just to get all the flavors meld together. I have my Instant Pot on the saute function, and that's why you see the steam coming up from the pot. Next, we're gonna add our lentils, and you rinse your lentils before you cook them just so you make sure all the dirt is off of them. You add them to the pot. They cook pretty quickly. You stir them around, make sure that everything is well combined. Next, we're gonna add some unsweetened, unsalted almond butter. This is gonna give the soup some body, give it like a little bit of thickness so it's not so thin, and add some fat to the soup. And we will stir it up to make sure that everything is well combined. Now that we've got everything in the pot, we're going to add the lid to the Instant Pot. We did leave out two ingredients. That was the spinach and the nutritional yeast. We will add those ingredients at the end. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is set the Instant Pot on manual and for 15 minutes. Let it come up to pressure, cook for the 15 minutes, and let the pressure come down, and the soup will be completely finished. The soup is now done. We're gonna take the lid off of the pressure cooker, and the steam is just gonna steam the camera. And then what we're gonna do is add the spinach and the nutritional yeast to the pot, and then we can get ready to serve. Then we're gonna add our quote unquote cheese, the nutritional yeast. You can use more or less of this if you'd like. And then we'll stir it in and then get ready for our spinach. So I'm adding the spinach. You can use whatever you want. Another good option is kale. You can use collard greens. You can use whatever kind of green you'd like. I like spinach because it's easy to wilt down and it's cheap. That's really the truth, it's cheap. And all you do is just cover the spinach with the soup, and you'll see in just a second how easily the spinach sort of cooks down, if you will, and it still has its green texture. It doesn't cook too much. And then once you get this all combined well, all you have to do is just serve it and eat it. So what do you think? Will you try this recipe? Does it look yummy to you? What would you do differently if you made the recipe? If you want to see more recipes, you can click the description box down below and see a playlist of all of my recipes that I have listed on YouTube, but you can also check me out on Instagram and find my day-to-day posts so you can see what I'm eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.